I think the last video got cut off, technical problem. I just wanted to make a few brief remarks to supplement that about the Phaedo, the third reading that we're looking at, and how, you know, one is really struck, I think, upon reading the Bhagavad Gita. If you come from a Western tradition and you're familiar with Western philosophy, is how reminiscent of Plato and Socrates, the theory of death, the attitudes towards death that Krishna expresses to Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita. Because if you move to the Phaedo, of which I've given you just a brief excerpt, which I think outlines Plato's claims about the nature of death, that it is simply the separation of soul and body. You know, the very dramatic setting of the Phaedo is the day of Socrates' death. He's been convicted, justly or not, of corrupting the youth of Athens and being rather heterodox in his religious beliefs, but he's been convicted of those charges, and the sentence was death, and he's been waiting some time in a jail to have that sentence carried out for various complications. But the day has come, and his friends have come to be with him. And one would think, with the intention of being good friends and comforting him in his hour of need, and he immediately sets a different tone and basically says to them, "Why are you so sad? Why are you all so upset? And why do you think that I'm upset? Yes, today I'll die, but what does that really mean?" And he expresses a very confident notion that whatever happens, this is not his end. That is, that Socrates, like Krishna, believes that there is something eternal to him, something which the notion of death simply does not apply. And that is his soul. It's not the kind of thing that can die. What is death? Well, death certainly is the end of the body, and that can be very disturbing to those who are left behind. It is the destruction of the body, but what am I? Am I my body? Am I not something else? Or if I regard myself as a whole, the kind of being I am, it would seem that there is a part of me, my soul or my mind or my intellect, which is not physical and to which the concept of death does not apply. And moreover, being a philosopher, he says, he's waited for this day for quite a long time, and not with trepidation, because the separation of the soul from the body is in a way the liberation. Not just the soul, but the soul as mind. Socrates tells him that you know, the kind of truth that he and every philosopher has been looking for all his life now is going to be available to him in a purer form, in a much more intimate form. It has to do with his notion of what true knowledge is and his idealism with regard to reality. But a great promise is to be fulfilled in death. A liberation of the intellect from the chains of the body, the prison house of the body, to a new and better form. Very interesting, I think, different views, and very different views between Epicurus on the one hand and Plato and the Bhagavad Gita on the other, in terms of the theory of death. And what is your job? Well, your job is to just think. And to think about these things. But I think you may discover in one or other of these texts something that resonates with what you probably already think with regard to death. Again, whether you've articulated it to yourself or not, somewhere in you is a philosopher who has some ideas and has done some thinking about these things, as we all have, the big issues. Which one do you think is closer to what you view as the real nature of death?